Hey, and welcome to my video tutorial on how to get custom animation into the Source Filmmaker. To begin with, you want to go into Maya and then open your scene for the character that you're going to be animating. I think I'm going to animate one of the TF2 models. You want to go to File, Open, and then you want to change, browse to your sourcesdk content folder. Chill for me, it's here, then TF, model source, player, and then pick a player you're going to animate. I think I'll use the scout, and parts, Maya, and open one of these files. The rig file has the rig which you can animate in Maya and everything, but I'm pretty pants at Maya, so I'll just use the reference file and animate it in something else. So I'll open this file, and then we want to export it as an fbx file, which so our other program can read. So we'll just save this as scout.fbx, export, and then ignore this error that comes up. Then you'll want to import your fbx file into the animation program which you're going to be using. I like to use Motion Builder for characters. So we just go to File, FBX Import, import our scout, and then just begin animating. And there's other video tutorials on how to use this program, so I'll just pick it up when I'm done animating. Okay, we've got an animation on a scout here, which we'll want to get into the Source Filmmaker. So to begin doing that, we're going to go to File, and export this animation. Export it as an FBX file. You can just call it Scout Dance. Export, overwrite, yes. Then we'll go back to Maya and just import that file we just made. Hit import. And then you want to go down here and resize your timeline, so you can see all your animation, and then just check if it looks okay. Yeah, that looks good. We'll put that in Source Filmmaker. So we'll just go to File, Export All, then change your format to Valve DMX, then save it somewhere. I'm gonna call this Scout Dance as well. Take a while to just render the animation, and then we'll go into Source Filmmaker. Okay, now we're in Source Filmmaker, and the first thing you want to do is spawn as the class that you want to animate. So go to your viewport, press F11, then F10, and spawn as the class that you want to animate. In my case, a scout. Press F11, then F10 to get back to your editor. Click Record Take. Uncheck these top three options, which are checked by default, and hit record. Just wait a second, and hit F11 and F10 again, and then we have me as a scout. And then you want to go to your timeline, click the shot, then right click it, go create animation set, type in the name of the character you're playing as, which will be scout. Okay. To animation set editor, and that you'll see by default all these channels are selected, and we don't want that, otherwise our animation will turn into spaghetti when we import it. So you want to uncheck them all by clicking anywhere, and then hold down control while you click body, arms, fingers, and legs, then right click, import animation, and then import the file which you saved as a DMX, and hit yes. Then double click your shot, and you'll see the animation set that you made for your character. It doesn't begin at the start of the clip, so you'll need to drag this over to when the clip begins, and then we can see that our animation is in game and playing properly. There is something to note here though, that make sure you are definitely standing in the exact spot that you want the animation to play at, because you won't be able to change it if you have animation on your hips, because usually if you want to move where your model is, you just select the pelvis channel and then you move your character somewhere. Let's see, we wanted him here instead, and maybe facing this way. And then when we play the animation back, it starts going crazy. So let's play that again. And when you play your animation back, it starts going completely crazy. So make sure your character is in the right spots, so you don't have to move him around.